Welcome back. This is Innk, and in this series of problems, we're going to apply, I call it supernodal analysis. So it's just basically nodal analysis, node voltage method, and supernode. We've done a series of problems with node voltage method and the supernode method. Those will be located in the playlist under the channel. In this case, these problems are going to mainly require us to use nodal analysis because they contain mostly voltage source, either dependent or independent. So as circuit analyzers, we need to know which tool is appropriate for the task at hand. And in this case, or in this series of videos, it's mostly going to be nodal analysis. So for this problem, we see that we have a dependent voltage source in 2i. And a independent voltage source 8 volts. We need to determine Vx, find Vx, and find I. So we start off by naming our terminals. So to find I, we need to know this terminal. To find Vx, we need to know this terminal. In order to know both of those terminals, we need to know this terminal, the voltage at those terminals. So let's call it V1. We do things from left to right. V1, V2, and V3. Starting from V1, we apply KCL. So KCL from V1, so that's V1. And as always, let's include our ground, which is 0 volts. So at V1, so from V1 with reference to V2, so that's V1 minus V2. Or let's start V1 with reference to the 8 volt source, which is in the lower left of the circuit. The voltage source we see in a positive terminal, so V1 minus a positive 8, which is just V1 minus 8. That's all over 1 ohms, plus V1 minus V2, that's all over 2 ohms, plus V1 with reference to V3. So that's V1 minus V3, all over 4 ohms, and that is equal to 0. Now we go to terminal V2, applying KCL. We say V2 with reference to V1, that's all over 2 ohms, plus V2 with reference to V3, so minus V3. We'd see that we have a dependent voltage source in that branch with a 6 ohms resistor. So V2 with reference to V3 is V2 minus the voltage at the terminal V3, so that's minus V3. Then looking at the dependent voltage source, we're looking at the negative terminal, so that's V2 minus a negative 2i, so that's give us a positive 2i, all over 6 ohms, and looking at V2 minus 0 volts, all over 1 ohms, and that's equal to 0. Terminal V3. Same thing again, so V3 with reference to V2 says V3 minus V2. Now from V3, we're looking at the positive terminal of 2i. So the positive terminal of the dependent voltage source 2i, so that's minus a positive, so that's minus 2i. And that's all over 6 ohms. Moving on, so we say V3 with reference to ground, so that's 0 volts. All over 1 ohms, plus V3 with reference to V1, all over 4 ohms, and that is equal to 0. We know that we want to find I and Vx. Notice that the relationship between I and V2, because knowing the voltage at terminal V2 allows us to find the current in that branch, which is this current flowing from V2 to ground. In that case, we can say I is related to V2 all over R, and in this case R is equal to 1 ohms. So V2 divided, so voltage divided by R is going to give us current, correct? So we're going to take the coefficient of V2, so we can say equals V2. Now solving all three equations, so we have three equations, three unknowns, so simultaneously you know, I don't know how you pronounce that one, but simultaneous equation or simultaneous equations give us the following answer. So V1 is going to equal to 5.18 volts. V2 is going to equal to 1.41 volts. V3 is going to equal to 1.41 volts. So V2 is equal to V3. Now, moving back to the I, now, as we said, it's going to equal to V2. So I is equal to V2. So V2 in that case is 1.41 volts, correct? And R is 1 ohms. And that is going to equal to 1.41 amp. So when we say that I is equal to V2, it is equal to the coefficient or the magnitude of the voltage. So that's the current I. Finding Vx. Vx is equal to V3. It's the same thing again. Because the current, remember the current in this case, or we're talking about this portion right here. So the current in that case is going to equal to V3 all over R, which is going to equal to V3, right? So if to find the voltage, I times R, R is 1. So the voltage is just basically I times R. And that's going to equal to V3. So in this case, the voltage, Vx, is equal to V3. Basically, what we're saying in this portion is the current is going to equal to the coefficient or the magnitude of V3. And because the resistor is 1 ohms, so the magnitude of V3 is still V3. So V3 times R is going to be V3. So thus, Vx is equal to V3. And that's it. See you in the next problem. Bye.